Hello guys, welcome back to RoboSense. So today we'll be discussing about an Hall effect sensor. So Hall effect sensors are one of the magnetic sensors which senses the magnetic intensity.
Suppose we just need to find the pole of the neodymium magnet. So the thing is, now if I make it close to this neodymium magnet, we'll see that it is close to the light is LED is glowing and the value turns to 1. That means it is the North Pole.
So here is one Hall effect sensor. You can see this one is a Hall effect sensor. So it has got 4 pins. It has got an analog output, digital output, VCC and ground as usual. So what is the main uses of Hall effect sensor? See, if there is no paper in this slot, then this Hall effect sensor actually senses that there is no paper, so the printer should not work and it should ask for more papers. This is one of the applications of Hall effect sensors. So in our next video, we'll be discussing about wireless charging modules. So this is one of the wireless charging modules. So we'll be talking about the whole thing in full detail in the next video. And for these wireless charging modules to be, therefore we are talking about this Hall effect sensor, and I hope you get all the required information in this video. So we will be just showing you the code along with this neodymium magnet. So this magnet is very strong, so we'll be showing you how this magnet interferes with this Hall effect sensor and how the values will be changing very frequently. This is p-type semiconductor. Actually, Hall effect sensors and all of the sensors used in these days are mainly semiconductors. But this is not that much accurate as magnetometers, so we'll be talking about those things in our next videos. So this is it, let's move on to the code part.
Guys, we are going to explain the Hall effect principle. Now, the Hall effect sensor consists of an p-type semiconductor which oftenly comprises of indium antimonide compound, and the basic principle is that when you apply a DC voltage across this Hall effect sensor, incoming or an outgoing magnetic field that can be of different intensities, that can be of uniform or non-uniform magnetic field, senses the intensity of the magnetic field and produces an proportional voltage that is called the Hall voltage. Now this is the Hall effect sensor. Now it has got 4 pins, A0 for analog output, D0 that is for digital output, ground and VCC. Now we have got a potentiometer to set this sensitivity of this sensor. Now we are going to connect it to the microcontroller, which is the Arduino here. Now the thing is, D0 is connected to pin number 2. Now the red one is the ground one, that is connected to the ground, and the middle one is the VCC, that is connected to the 5 volt. It is connected, then we can see a light glowing up. Now moving towards the, now this is the basic code of the Hall effect sensor. Because this is a digital sensor, that means the analog value which has been getting from the Hall effect sensor, we are converting it to digital. Therefore we do not need to actually put an algorithm to convert all this analog value to digital one. So we will just get the value as 1 or 0. Therefore we do not need to give so much of codes, just need to read those values from the digital pin. Now you can see that end sensor is equal to digital read HS, and HS is the pin number 2. So from pin number 2, whatever the digital value will be getting, that has to be converted to digital part, and then we will be printing it in the serial monitor. Now just open the serial monitor, you can see that all the values are 0. Now this is a neodymium magnet. So we just need to find, suppose we just need to find the pole of the neodymium magnet. So the thing is, now if I make it close to this neodymium magnet, we'll see that it is close to the light is LED is glowing and the value turns to 1. That means it is the North Pole. Okay, so yes, therefore Hall sensors are of different types, and we can set it as set as our desired to be detection for forage detection to be North Pole or South Pole. So in this case you can see that this is the North Pole. So if I make it close, then it glows up. If I make this thing close to this thing, it does not glow because this is South Pole. So it does not detect the South Pole. This is the thing, and this is the North Pole. See, the thing is, these Hall effect sensors are used widely, but these are not that much accurate. But much more accurate sensors are magnetometers, which are available, and in the next videos we'll be talking about magnetometers. So this is the basic principle of Hall effect sensor and its working, and we can actually think of many applications in the coming video. So stay tuned.
Thank you very much guys for watching my video, and do not forget to like, subscribe and share for more videos, and stay tuned because we are coming with these wireless charging modules, and we'll show you the magic of wireless charging, and we'll surely bust the myth of Tesla coil. Thank you very much.